A year ago, Morgan Shepherd led this race. He has led it today. He finished 13th. He said it was that win.
Oh! Out of control goes Kenseth.
And over on his roof.
Get back on the wheels.
A wild ride for the Daytona 500 winner, Matt Kenseth.
You see Matt moving in there. You can see him trying to get the window net down. There he comes out.
He's coming out. That's good to see. That was Katie Kenseth, his wife, there. That's a scary moment for anybody. Definitely a scary moment for Matt.
See Matt a little bit frustrated, angry.
Didn't see exactly what caused that. We just saw him kind of bounce out of line there.
Just know at this time of the race that the guys are going to start giving less and
taking
bumping
more.
Harder. And all it takes is just a little bit there when you're in the middle and no saving. Just a testament to the safety of these cars, too. They can take a lick like that. See, Matt's in second place right here behind Ryan Newman. See what happens. He goes to block.
Comes back in line. It looks like he may get a tap. Yeah, he gets a tap from David Ragan.
Yep.
Car gets out of shape and then just pirouettes on its left side and goes over.
And we talk about the bump drafting has to be done on the straightaway. And you can see, even on the straightaway, if you get hit too hard, it just takes the steering wheel out of your hands as a driver.
This was the scary part right here when he's on his roof for so long. Looked for a minute like he might save it, but then got down there. Golly, this is tough.
Yeah, and Matt really did a great job. If he goes up in front, he takes out 15 or 18 cars. So he did a great job of not creating that situation.
Let's see what Dale Earnhardt Jr. saw here as the contact took place right in front of him.
Everybody jockey for position here. Oh, Matt gets a shove.
Three wide. Wrecking down low. You're clear right there. Clear all around. They wreck behind.
John West Townley going by, you see he sees Kenseth's car just rolling over side by side.
And you could see in that last shot from Dale Jr.'s that it literally lifted the back of the car off the ground whenever David Ragan.
Yeah, you see the back end come off the ground on the 16. There's just no way to control that. It's a strange way to see one flip. You don't normally see them do that.
No, but these cars have a liftoff point of getting off the ground about 170 miles an hour, and no matter with all these safety innovations that NASCAR has put into these cars, you still these cars get in that right situation or wrong situation.
They have to get in the perfect spot. Yeah.
Second time in 3 years we've seen a car go on its roof here. 2 years ago it was Kyle Busch who had a violent rollover down the back straightaway, and now this year it is another.